Hi, and welcome to this Fornav Coffee Break. My name is René Brummel. I'm a product specialist at Fornav, and I will be your presenter today. As this coffee break is live, you can ask your questions via the GoToWebinar question window. We will answer them at the end of the coffee break. Today, we're going to look at adding totals to a Business Central report. To demonstrate how to add totals, we will use the standard reports from the Fornav report pack. I will add and calculate totals in a variety of ways. However, you can add totals to any Fornav report from any extension using the instructions from this coffee break. To demonstrate how to add totals to Business Central reports, I'm going to use these steps. The prerequisites, what do I need to get going? In step two, I will have a look at adding simple totals to the customer list. In step three, we will look at the totals on the sales invoice. In the fourth and final step, I will place the sales invoice totals in the bottom of the page. Let's start with the first step. Today, I will be adding totals in a Business Central on-premise Docker installation with the Business Central 2020 Wavefront release. I have installed the Fornav extension and I have executed the step-by-step wizard from the assisted setup to get started. Of course, everything I do today is also available on the Business Central cloud environment. I also have the Fornav Designer installed on my PC. The Fornav Designer can be downloaded from the Fornav website. One of the first questions a developer asks about Fornav tends to be, how do I calculate totals? That makes sense. Totaling is one of the main things you want a report to do. No reason in having an invoice report without totals. Our answer is always a bit baffling though. You don't need to calculate totals. Fornav does it for you. But what do you need to do to let Fornav calculate the totals? Let's have a look. And to calculate totals, I'm going to play around with the Fornav customer list. I'll open it in the designer. And what I want to do is in the bottom of the report, I want to add the totals for the list balance LCY and the list net change LCY. So the first thing I need to do is add a footer because that's where I want to place my totals. So I will insert a footer and I will put it above my master footer. And in this footer, I will place the fields that I want to total. So I will place the balance LCY there. And I'm going to add the net change LCY there. And of course, I'm going to need some captions as well. So let's use the balance LCY caption. And let's use the net change LCY caption. And to make it look really nice, I'm going to add the total text in front of my caption. So I'm going to use my standard captions from my current report and add total plus, then a space and plus again. And let me just copy this so I don't need to type it out every time. And let's make this bold and orange so it all stands out a little bit. And let's preview our report and see what it does. So scrolling all the way to the end of the report, you will notice that I have my orange total fields and the totals are correct, are calculated for me and they are correct because I have calculated them before myself just to make sure everything was all right. And I, of course, I have my total balance caption and my total net change caption. So what happened in my report that Fornav started to calculate my totals? As soon as I add a footer and I add amounts or any sorts of decimals to that footer, in the data item, there is a property called total fields. And in that property, Fornav places all the fields that have been added to whatever footer. You can see it right here. There's the balance LCY and the net change LCY. And for those fields, Fornav will start to maintain the totals. So that's all you need to do in order to have the totals created in Fornav. A question we get very often is how do we place these totals in the bottom? Well, of course, you can just place the footer in the bottom. Just say place in bottom, yes. And let's preview again, see what it does. And you'll notice that totals have been placed in the bottom because now the footer has been placed in the bottom. So how does totaling work on a sales invoice? Let's go and have a look at that. So once again, go to my Business Central environment. And instead of the customer list, I'm going to be checking out my sales template. So let's go and design this in FourNav. Now on the sales documents, of course, there's a total already because otherwise it wouldn't really be a usable invoice. So we already have the amount and the amount including VAT. Now, what we did on the sales invoice is a bit like cheating because we just used the header.amount. The amount is a flow field on the header fields. So we can simply get those and calculate them. But what if I want to add something else other than the amount or the amount including VAT? What if I want a total for all of the quantities on my invoice? Let's do the same thing we just did. Let's go and insert a footer. And on this footer, I'm going to add the quantity field. And of course, just so we know what it is, we use the quantity caption as well. And just because we can, we're going to add the total query port totals caption as well, because it's still in my clipboard and it's really easy to add. Let's make this yellow so it stands out a little bit. And let's go and preview again. So there it is, my total quantity is 145, which adds up. I have 25 on my first line and 120 on my second line, so that's 145. So my totals here are correct as well. And when we go back to the FourNav Designer, we go back to the data item, we will see once again that the quantity field has been added to the total fields. The amount was already there because on the lines footer, we use the header.amount. But on the transport header and footer, we use the line amount. This is another coffee break video we did. You can find it in our recorded coffee breaks on how to add transport headers and footers. So, as I said before, a lot of people ask us, how do we place these totals in the bottom? Of course, I said earlier that's fairly easy because all you need to do is place this footer in the bottom. So let's go and do that and see what happens. Place in bottom to yes. And let's preview. And when I preview this report, you will notice that my totals has been placed in the bottom, but my VAT stuff has disappeared. That's been pushed to the second page. So what has happened there? If I look at my FourNav Designer, you will notice that my footer here is above my VAT amount line data item and my VAT clause data item. This makes sense because you obviously want the lines to be displayed in above the VAT stuff. But if I want to place the totals in the bottom, this is of course a bit tricky. So what do I do? Fortunately, FourNav just lets me add a new footer, but now on the header section. So I'm going to insert a new footer and move this up as well. And what I can do is simply grab all of my stuff from my line footer and place it in my header footer. And let's add my quantity as well. Let's put it there. And then, of course, I can remove my lines footer and the new quantity footer I made. And a new footer on the header will be placed in the bottom. And let's preview this. Now I have my lines, I have my VAT stuff, and then I have all of my quantity stuff in the bottom, right above the normal footer I have on my invoice. So let's recap what we just did. In Business Central, we have added totals to the customer list. We saw that all we have to do is place the fields we want to total in a footer. ForNav then calculates the totals for us. We can do the same on a sales invoice or any other document. We can also place totals on footers that are on different data items. Of course, we can also use the ForNav scripting to maintain or calculate the totals, but that is a story for another coffee break. Thank you for listening to me so far. Mark, do we have any questions?
Thanks, René, for this presentation. And I think you have been very clear because at this moment, we don't have any questions yet, but we're going to give the people in the audience a moment to type in some questions while we go to the next slide. So if you want to know more about the product or the things that René just showed, there's a couple of interesting resources that you can go to. Of course, first and foremost, our website, fornav.com, where you can find all the information about the product, including the download of the designer. If you want to directly go to the download, just type in /download, and you can go to the download page. If you want to download the report pack for Business Central, you can go to Microsoft AppSource and search for ForNav. Here you can download a trial version. The trial version is actually the full product. We don't hide any features if you install the app from AppSource. The only thing that we do without a license is print the watermark on the report. And as soon as you acquire a license, we remove the watermark, and you can acquire a license directly from the app by informing us that you want to move forward with the product. On YouTube, you can find all the past recordings of the coffee breaks, as well as the webinars that we host when we release new versions of the product. Simply go to youtube.com/fornavreports. If after all these goodies, you still have any questions, please send them to support@fornav.com. Your email will end up in our support ticketing system. And the general rule of thumb is that we answer within 24 hours and often even much quicker. We try to do same business day. So currently we don't have any questions yet, so let's wrap up. If you want to see the list of coffee breaks that we do in the future, you can go to fornav.com/coffee break. Here you can find a list of coffee breaks that have not yet been presented. We are going to continue with the coffee breaks until the summer. And then after the summer vacation, we're going to continue. So let's go to the last slide. If you cannot find the answer to your question in either the YouTube list of past coffee breaks or the list of future coffee breaks, don't hesitate to send your topic suggestion to us in an email to info@fornav.com. If we select your suggestion to do a coffee break, you will win two prizes. The first one is we will answer your question in a personal coffee break. And the second one is that we will give you a gift certificate for thanking you helping us come up with coffee break suggestions. So with that, thank you for attending the coffee break today. I hope to see you in the next episode. And thanks, René, for presenting today. Bye.
You're welcome. Bye.